today, oh God. And we thank you, God, because we're offering our praise, God, today. We're offering our worship today. We're offering our thanksgiving today, oh God, for the great and mighty things that you continue to do in our life. Now, as you release those hands, release a praise and give God a praise and a glory this morning, because we believe that it is already done.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Anybody glad that we've made it to the 23rd of December? Anybody glad that God has brought you through this year? We're almost at the end of it, and we're into the season of celebration of the Son of God. Anybody glad this morning that God didn't leave us where we were, but he sent his only begotten Son? He loved us that much that he gave us his Son. His Son is now a member of the human race forever. What a gift. What a gift. What a gift. And I know the enemy has tried to attack us as a body of Christ. So many of us in this house have lost loved ones in this last quarter of the year. So many of us are dealing with trials and issues of health. So many of us are dealing with things, but if God's still been good to you, could you just take 5 seconds and celebrate him? If God's still been your way maker, can you take 5 seconds and give him glory? If God's still been your covenant keeper, can you take 5 seconds and just thank him? If God's still been your provider, can you just take 5 seconds and thank him? If God's still been your protector, if God has promised to be your father and your mother, if God has promised to be everything that you've needed, just take 5 seconds and give him glory. Lord, you are good, and your mercy endures forever. And people from every nation and tongues, they celebrate in this season the birth of your Son. We give you glory, God, because we know that if it wasn't for your Son, we wouldn't have life in this moment. And because of his life, we have life forevermore. So God, you are good, and your mercy endures forever. God, you are good, and your mercy endures forever. Somebody say that. God, you are good, and your mercy endures forever. Come on, let's sing it with me. Lord, you are good. Say, Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever. Come on, let's sing it real loud. Say, Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever. Can you say it again, everybody? Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever. One more time, let's say it real loud. Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Come on, let's worship him this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. Sing it real loud again. Say, hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. Now shout it out, say, you are good. Come on, everybody, clap your hands on it. We serve a good God. He's good all the time, and we give you all the praise. Yeah, come on, say it. Lord, you are good. Say, Lord, you are. Your mercy endureth forever. Come on, don't play this morning. Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth ever. People from every nation and tongue. People from every nation and tongue. From generation to generation, we worship you. Come on, raise it real loud. Hallelujah. You for who you are and for what you gave in your Son. Say, we worship you. Yes, hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. Now shout it out real loud. Say, you are good all the time, all the time, all the time.
good.
You are.
Come on, raise it real loud.
You are good all the time. All the time. You are. Say it real loud again. Say you are good. No matter what comes my way. All the time. You are good to me. Yes, you are. You are. Yes, you are. All the time. All the time. You are. Time, all the time, you've been good to me. Let me hear you say it. Come on, you are. Yeah, that's it right there. Come on, say it. You woke me up this morning, started me on my way. I'm grateful this morning. Hey, say you are good all the time, all the time. You've been good to me. All the time, people from every nation and tongues. Oh, people from every nation and tongue, from generation to, we worship you. We were. Hey, that's it. Come on, that's it right there, church. Hallelujah. Yes, we do. We give it to you. Yay. That's it. For who you are. Come on, let's raise it real loud to the Lord. You're so worthy of our worship. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship you for who you are, for who you are, for who you are, for who you are, for who you are. Now shout it out, you are good. You know that your praise confuses the enemy. He doesn't understand how he's attacked you all week long. But you're here on this Sunday morning shouting out how good God is. I need you to know that your praise confuses the enemy. He doesn't understand how you can stand here this morning and say, God, you've been good to me, even though I've lost some stuff, even though some stuff has happened to me. He doesn't understand how you could stand here and say, God, you are still good. Hallelujah. But that's for him to worry about. What we know is we have a God who is bigger, who is stronger than any other. We don't fight our battles for ourselves. We fight knowing that the battle's already won. Hallelujah. 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 And so in this Christmas season, it's only appropriate to sing a few hymns that celebrate the Lord, thanking him for the gift of Christ. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth. God and sinners reconciled. Come on, let's sing this, everybody. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild. God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all the nations rise. Join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Let's do the third verse. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace. Hail the heaven-born Prince of... Hail the Son of Righteousness. The Son of Righteousness. Light and life. Light and life to all he brings. Risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by. Born that man no more may die. Born to raise the son of earth. Born to give him second birth. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the
the newborn King. Oh, come, holy faithful, joyful and triumphant, oh, come, oh, come to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet thee. Born this happy morning. Born this happy morn. Jesus, to thee be. Jesus, to thee be all glory. Give word of the Father. Of the Father, now in flesh appear. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
That's it. Come on, sing it to him.
You're altogether lovely.
Hallelujah.
Altogether worthy.
Come on, sing.
Altogether wonderful to me.
Can we just declare it now? I'll never know how much it costs.
And I'll never know how much it costs.
That's why you came
to see my sins upon that cross.
That's why you came.
I never know how much it costs to see my sins. I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin, yeah, my sin upon them.
Come on, tell them real good.
I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross.
That's the only reason why Christ came, y'all.
So here I am to worship, and here I am to bow down, and here I am to say that you're my God.
Come on, can we declare it?
You're altogether lovely. You're altogether worthy. You're altogether wonderful to me. And here I am to worship.
Come on, say.
Here I am to.
Come on, say it to him.
And here I am too.
That when the world celebrates presence, I celebrate that
you're my, oh, you're all together. You're all together
altogether wonderful, altogether wonderful to me. Just follow me right here. And this is why I can declare this. The song says, my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself. I give myself to you. Is that your heart's desire this morning, church? He gave it for you. Can you give it back? My life is not my own. To you I belong. To you I belong. I give myself away. I give myself. I give myself to you, to you. He gave it for you. Will you receive him now? Come on, tell him. My life is not my own. To you I belong, God. To you I belong. I give myself, come on. I give myself. I give myself to you. One more time. Can you just turn it all over to him and tell him real now? My life is not my own. To you I belong. To you I belong. I give myself. I give myself to you. One more time. Let's raise it real loud in the house. Break the music. Come on, say, my life is not mine. That's it right there. Come on, tell him. To you I belong. Come on, real loud. Come on, say, I give myself. Oh, yes. I give myself to you, Lord. One more time, raise it real loud to the Lord. Say, my life is not my own. You gave it for me, I give it back to you. I belong. Oh, I give myself. I give myself to you, Lord. And here I am to worship. And here I am to bow down. And here I am to say, you're my God, oh God, you're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful, together wonderful to me. Here I am to worship. That's the first thing. Here I am to bow. That's the second thing. Here I am to say, the most important thing is, you're my, that's it, and you're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether worthy, and you're more than wonderful, altogether wonderful to my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself. I give myself to you. To you. I don't know why I'm saying here, but somebody came in here thinking that you own it all, but he already owns you. Just give up right now and give him your life and let him have it. Let him have it. To you I be. That's the whole purpose for the season, was that God would send his son to die and to be risen from the dead so that he can live his life in you. Will you receive that life now? Declare it. My life is not my own. He's here to give it. To you I belong. You make that declaration, he fills you. I give myself. I give myself to you. One last time, reel it down, just the music. Come on, say, my life is not my own. Hey, God, to you I belong. In this season, I give myself. I give myself to you. Last time, here I am to worship. Here I am to bow. Here I am to say. Here I am to say that you're my. No matter how many gifts I get, if I don't get one, you're all together. No matter if I don't get another gift, you're all together worth. And most importantly, you're all together wonderful. wonderful, just let him know. If he's wonderful, just let him know. If he's wonderful to you, if he's the greatest gift you've ever received, just let him know right there. Just let him know right there. Open up your mouth and let him know right there. You're altogether wonderful. You're altogether lovely. You're altogether worthy. I love you, God. I celebrate you. I thank you for the gift of Christ. I thank you for the gift of Christ, because with Christ I have it all. In Christ I have it all. With Christ I have everything I need. I don't need another gift under the tree. I have it all. I have it all. Somebody say, I have it all. I have it all. You've officially been called to worship.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Good morning, church. Do we have any first-time visitors? May you please stand. On behalf of Pastor and First Lady and the Crystal Tabernacle Church, we would like to thank you for worshiping with us and pray that you come back again. Crystal Tabernacle family, may you please take your time to greet each other.
Come on, Crystal Tab, let somebody feel the love of Jesus this morning. Shake a hand, greet somebody, give them a hug. Come on, say,
the Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. So easy. So easy. So easy. So easy to love. In me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. So easy. So easy. So easy. So easy to love. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. So easy. So easy. So easy. So easy to love. One more time, say, the Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. So easy. So easy. So easy.
I'm gonna give you one last time. Come on, everybody. So easy to love. Last time, as you make your way back to your seats, everybody say,
the Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. So easy. easy. So easy. So easy to love.
Please turn your attention to the screen for this morning's announcements.
Good morning and welcome to Christian Tabernacle, where our mission is to engage, equip, and empower the world to become explosive disciples. Is this your first time at Christian Tabernacle? If so, we're glad to have you with us. Here at Christian Tabernacle, we're focusing on the critical seeds: connect, contribute, and celebrate. We've designed today's service with you in mind. In just a few moments, we'll sing a few songs, and then we'll hear a life-changing word. If you would like to get to know us a little better, please fill out the visitor information portion of the welcome packet and drop it in the offering bucket, or give it to one of our Love First technicians. Again, thank you for coming today. We hope that you enjoy your time here. Oh, and by the way, here's what's happening at the Tab. And now it's time to bring in the new year with the Tab by joining us for our New Year's Eve service on December 31st at 10 p.m. It's never too late to be what you should be. Doors will be open at 9:30 p.m. It's never too late to
start over again. The Women of the Word presents.
The Women of the Word is looking for a few good women to join the WOW implementation team. The WOW implementation team will be responsible for planning the activities for the Women of the Word for each month. To register for the WOW implementation team, please be sure to see First Lady Darlene if you are interested. Get ready, get ready, get ready. We are entering into Master Life 4, the Disciples' Mission, which will be facilitated by Minister Lanisha Smith. Come for a great discussion as we continue to dig deeper in the Word of God. Please see Reverend Rufus Riddick for your books. Books are available for $10. We look forward to learning and growing together.
Please remember that the TABS Transportation Ministry is available to serve you. If you desire to be picked up, please call the church office each week by Wednesday at noon. If you want to stay up to date and connected with us, give us a like on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, check us out on YouTube, or tell those who missed out about our frequently updated live feed. This concludes our weekly announcement. We thank you again for coming to see us. Pray that you have a great weekend. Remember, Tab family, we are touching to transform.
Amen. 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 Let's give God some praise. Amen. Come on. Has he been good to you? Amen. Amen. Has he been good to you? Come on. You got one more week in this year. Has he been good to you? Has he been good to you? Amen. If God's been good to you, just look at your neighbor and say, he's been good to me. Come on. Tell your neighbor, I made it through. Amen. He's been good to me. Amen. I wanna share something with you real quick. While I was sitting here, waiting, you know, doing my praise and worship, I was sitting here, and my wife and my kids. We have a group, a family text that helps us keep up with each other. And when I was getting while I was sitting here, my daughters are on their way home from Houston. Amen. My daughters are on their way home from Houston, and I was getting texts because First Lady is at the airport to pick them up, and I'm sitting here, and my text keeps going off, and I know when I get a lot of buzzes, that means that they holding the conversation, and as they were holding the conversation, I began to read the text, and as I was reading the text, I looked at what it said, and I said, Brother Durst, can you put the text? I want to show you. Can I bring y'all into our conversation? Amen. Can I bring y'all into my conversation? Brother Durst, can you turn me up a little bit? Can you make that a little bit bigger? Let's make that a little bit bigger. I want y'all to see this, because this was some of us at this year. It says, we just landed, and we're in the garage. It says, something is wrong with the tires on the plane, and they're not letting us go down the runway yet. Here go Kaylee. Y'all just sitting over the top of the runway? No. We're not pulled to the terminal yet. We're on the runway. Tell them to just let y'all off. Y'all are on the ground, so y'all are safe now. Give me the next part. Y'all can walk from there. Did they let y'all off yet? No, Kaylin, they're trying to fix the tires. We're here. Are y'all off yet? No, we're about to get towed. That was funny, wasn't it? But the biggest part was that they landed. Okay, y'all missed that. And truth be told, God wanted me to tell some of y'all that y'all are here. That you have arrived. And sometimes some one of the most dangerous things that is to have people that's been waiting for you to show up to rush the process. Because even though you arrived, there are some final touches that God is doing in your life before he releases you. Good God, oh my God. God is doing something before he releases you, and you cannot get frustrated. You cannot get off, because it's not safe to get off until you get to your destination. I was so happy because the tires could have went bad while they were in the air. Y'all don't understand that. I told you all about a few years ago, me and my wife were sitting at the airport waiting on our flight, and it kept getting delayed. They wouldn't tell us why we couldn't get on the plane. So everybody was fussing because we couldn't get on the plane. Everybody wanted to get home, until finally they just came over the airport, over the airline, and said that the brakes don't work. We fussing because we hurrying, trying to hurry up and get somewhere, and they didn't want to tell us. But the reason why we couldn't get on the plane was because the brakes wasn't working. And don't let nobody tell you that you still got a long way to go, that you're not arrived. You are arrived, but God is fixing some stuff before he releases you. And this is what God showed me when I was reading that text while I was sitting right there. You saw me walk back there. It showed me that he says that even though you are landed, you are where you're supposed to be, you still need help getting to your final spot. It says that we're getting told. And there are some people that's been through some stuff all year long, and they finally landed, but they need some help to get to their final destination. Can God trust you to help lift somebody up and carry them the last leg of 2018? Because you don't know what people had to go through to get here. Some people lost loved ones and they made it and their tires are flat. This journey has knocked the wind out of a lot of us. And we just need somebody that we can trust to lift us up without dropping us, to get us to a place where God can release us for service. I wasn't worried, because once I kept going back to the top and said, we landed. You need to celebrate God, because after all you've been through, you made it. I know we still got another week left. He says this is the preparation to get you to your release. You're on the runway, but you landed. You're in a safe spot, but you landed. And you cannot allow anybody to try to force you or rush you to get off of something that God has not released you from yet. I know you've been praying that I get here. I'm here, but leave me alone. They're working on something. I know we're excited. We've been praying for some stuff, and finally they have arrived. And now we all of a sudden get impatient, because this is what we've been praying for. Let God do a perfect work. I tell y'all all the time, man. We gotta stop, because resurrection is a process. We want to handle people before God is finished with them. And they die on the runway. God Almighty. They die on the runway because they trying to please you and then letting God finish the work that he's already done. He's landed you in a safe spot, but he's touching up some stuff before he release you. Because if he release you before he finish up, before he touch up some stuff, some people will mess up what God has already started in your life. And so I looked at that and I told him, I said, let them fix the tires. And so now they're being told. So I'm excited. My daughter's to be here shortly. And I'm excited. But I'm so glad to see y'all. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. I'm glad all of you all made it out on today. I know some of y'all got some last minute shopping to do. So we're going to make sure we get y'all out of here so y'all can go spend y'all money and do what y'all have to do. But I'm just excited because this has been an amazing year here at the TAB. This has been an amazing year here at the TAB. And so we are excited. We want to continue to lift up those that have gone through this season, that have lost a loved one on Friday night as we were home, getting home. Me and First Lady had been out celebrating birthdays with friends of ours and went to a couple's get together that night. And when we got home, it was late and went to sleep and got a phone call at 2:30 in the morning from my niece that they just found her mother dead. And so we were praying for them, and we had to be there. Elder Kim and myself went over to be with them 3:00 in the morning. And so we want to just continue to pray for the families to lose someone so close to Christmas. And you lose your mother. You know my niece, she comes to church with the little baby and the little bush and her sister. So we want to continue to lift them up in prayer. Amen. Also for those that are dealing with some sicknesses, man, you know, we go through stuff, man, but we landed. And so we have to realize that God is working on us and God is perfecting us. And we have to learn how to in all things be content. Amen. And that he that has begun a good work in us is faithful to complete it. And so, you know, during this season, I don't take for granted. Today is my mother's birthday. 21 years ago, God took her home. Amen. Yesterday was my dad's birthday. And about 8 years ago, God took him home. And so it was kind of different. So yesterday, I laid around the house, and I really didn't want to do much. And people, they were trying to give me, but I just didn't feel like moving. You know, I just didn't feel like moving. I just wanted to be still because I'm always running. And yesterday, I just felt like I just wanted to be still. I wanted to be still. And I sat around and I've been still. And God is just refreshed. I feel refreshed and feel renewed. And again, so we just want to continue to pray. But listen, we have some amazing things going on here at the TAB. Next week is Women's Day. Amen. So invite your ladies, invite your friends. Amen. How do y'all like the new setup of the church? Amen. Looks kind of, amen, amen. I love, we sat around here. I told y'all me and James don't have nothing else better to do during the week. Amen. We are out of control. Amen. Amen. So we are, but then on New Year's Eve, I'm telling you, if you ever, I know you used to party back in the day, but if you want to come to a real Holy Ghost worship experience, meet us here at the TAB on New Year's Eve at 10 p.m. Amen. Amen. 10 p.m. We're going to roll out some exciting new stuff. Had some time to spend some time with our leaders on Wednesday, and we rolled out the visions for going forward for the ministry, and I believe that God is pleased. Amen, with where we are going in this season. So come on out, bring your friends. Amen. We got the overflow ready for those. If we're not worried about seats, we got the overflow. Come on in, be a part of this worship experience. Let's bring in 2019 together. 2019, our theme is what? Faith for new. Amen. We believe in God going to do something new in our lives. Amen. 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 Listen, it's offering time. It's offering time. If you need an envelope, our little love turkey. Wave that. Hold that or hold it up. Hold it up, sweetie. Come on. Walk down the aisle and hold it up. Come on. Hey, adjust it.
Come on. They go out Nutcracker star right there. Sister Justice was the star in the Nutcracker, I think it was. Amen. She was dancing all on Facebook and all over the world. Look at it. Hey, Justice, hit me one little spin like what you did. Do me one little spin. Hey, that was going on. Amen. Amen. You need an envelope. I love her. Technicians will serve you. Amen. 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 Listen, everyone just stand all over the building. Amen. Amen. This has been an amazing year. Amen. Our master life is amazing. Amen. All I'm saying, I'm not just excited about the quantity of growth. I'm excited about the spiritual growth around this ministry. Amen. Amen. Brother James Long on the door. Amen. 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 Listen, let me tell you something. Brother James told me last week that he got a doctor's report that wasn't favorable. And they ran some tests, and some tests came back, you know, and most of us would have went and crawled in the corner. Brother James went and got his red necktie, his white shirt, he on the door today, amen, amen. I tell you, when you believe in God, man, you don't allow what the doctors say to slip you back into some isolated place, amen. I'm believing God that God, while you are serving others, God is healing you, amen. Amen. Father, we thank you for this offering that we're about to receive. We thank you for every giver, God. We thank you for every hand, every heart. God, we even thank you for those that didn't have a tangible gift to give, but they had a desire to give, God. Meet them at their heart's desire, God. We pray that every seed this morning meets every need before every need even becomes a need. Father, this is our prayer. We believe it lines up with your will, so we believe we have what we ask of you. In Jesus' name, everybody say, everybody say, yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Say yeah, yeah, yeah. Say yeah, 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 yeah. 'Cause we're blessed in the city, we're blessed in the field. Come on, say it. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must cease. Why? For the devil is defeated. City. We're blessed in the field. Come on, say it. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must cease. For the devil is defeated. We are blessed. Come on, say it. Late in the midnight hour, what? God's gonna turn it around. Come on, say it. It's gonna work in my favor. Yes, it will. Just encourage yourself and say it. Say, late in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn it around and around and around and around and around. Everybody say, yeah, 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 yeah. Say it. And everybody say, yeah, 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 yeah. Everybody say, yeah. Say, yeah, yeah. Say, yeah. Everybody say, yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, you sound good. Say, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, everybody say, yeah. Say, yeah, yeah. Say, yeah, 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 yeah. 'Cause we're blessed in the city and we're blessed in the field. Come on, and we're blessed when we come. When we go, we cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must cease.
for the devil is defeated. We are blessed. God's gonna turn it around. Faith for the new. Amen, amen. As the word of God's about to come forth, we're blessing the city, we're blessing the field. We can be grateful for that, church. I know sometimes everything doesn't seem to go our way, but it's all right. We're still blessed in the city. We're still blessed in the field. And so as long as God gives us breath as we move into 2019, we want all our worship to be consistent. We want our worship to be focused. And we'll let it flow to Him. We'll let it flow to Him. The song declares, hallelujah. Flow to you. Flow to you. Let the river of my worship flow to you. Lord, I pray in all I do. Let the river of my worship flow to you. Like streams in the valley. Let the songs of my heart, let them rise to bless your name and flow to you, flow to you. Let my worship flow to you, Lord. Sing flow to you. Songs of my heart rise to bless your name like streams in the valley, the way they swell with the rain. Let the songs of my heart rise to bless your name and flow to you. Flow to you. sing it to him. Say it now. Say, let all my praise flow to you. Come on, like streams in the valley. When you're blessed, you let me overflow. Swim with the rain, hey. Like streams in the valley, hey. The way they swim with the rain. Let the songs of my heart, let the songs of my heart rise to bless your name. Rise to bless your name and flow to you. To you, Lord, yeah. Let my worship now say it, say flow to you.
Of God's word, if you could just stand as a show of worship. Luke chapter 2, verse 1 through 7, it says, and it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be counted, registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was one of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with his wife, with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for him in the inn. Verse number 6 says, so it was that while they were there, the days were completed and it was time for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. I want to talk to you this morning from the subject, a complicated gift. A complicated gift. Father, we pray this morning, God, that your will be done. Father, hide me behind your cross so that I too might marvel at your word on this morning. that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, let them be acceptable in thine sight. Oh Lord, you are my strength and you are my redeemer. Father, I pray, God, that you give me revelation, knowledge, and clarity of speech. Father, let lives be changed, hearts be fixed, and relationships be restored. In Jesus' name, amen. A complicated gift. One of the things that when you are entering into a relationship, sometimes even you don't understand what's going on in the relationship. Sometimes when you see people on Facebook or on Twitter, and when they talk about are you in a relationship, they say it's complicated. Because sometimes we are in relationship and sometimes we don't even know the whole and everything that's what's going on in the relationship. In this text, most of the time when we hear this text preached, we hear it preached around this time, around the holiday times, as the Christmas story. But this text right here is really talking about someone who's gifted, but it's complicated. It talks about how Mary, who was a virgin, and she wasn't even married yet. She only had a commitment from Joseph to marry her. And now she was his betrothed wife. And now what happens is, it says that an angel came and visited Mary and told her, you have found favor with God. And now you shall bring forth a son, and his name shall be called Jesus. She replies, how can this be true when I know not a man? How can I be pregnant? How can I have a gift in me when I know not a man? I have not been intimate. I don't have anybody that supports me. I don't have anyone that can help mentor me. How can I be gifted when I'm in this thing by myself? When I don't know a man. He says, you have been gifted. This child that you bring forth is done by the Holy Spirit. What is in you, man didn't do. What is in you, the Holy Spirit impregnated you, and you will bring forth a son in his time. If you don't believe me, your cousin Elizabeth is far advanced. She's 6 months pregnant now. Mary, once she accepts God's word of her life, once she hears from the angel tells her that, Mary says, let it be done as you say, and she accepts it. But you have to realize this, that she wasn't in this thing by herself. Mary was dedicated and committed to Joseph. And now Mary, who's a virgin, is now pregnant, and Joseph has nothing to do with it. You have to understand, sometimes for some of us who are gifted, sometimes we have to understand that it's hard being gifted and people not understanding about your gift. It becomes complicated. What do you mean? Complicated means that something, when God gives you, when God impregnates you, when God puts something in you, it requires you to be in relationship with others. The word complicated, if you look at the word complicated, it talks about consisting of interconnected parts. So just because God puts it in you, it's not for you by yourself. It requires you to be connected with others. And truth be told, the reason why it's complicated is because it's difficult for people around you and even you to understand. Okay, it's arranged, it's elaborate, it's difficult to understand, analyze, or solve because people don't understand this. Let me see why. Let me tell you why they don't understand it. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, it says, the person without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, but considers them foolishness and cannot understand them because they are discerned only through the Spirit. You must understand, and you can't get upset when people don't understand what's going on with you when it's done in the Spirit, because they're looking at it through carnal eyes. And sometimes you have to understand, that's why it's complicated, because the Spirit is doing something that the natural eyes don't understand. So what God has to do is he sends the angel now to Joseph to tell Joseph, Mary hasn't been cheating on you. Mary has not stepped out on you. Mary has not been hanging out with the cable man or the plumber. Mary, what is going on in Mary? I did it. Because what you must understand is that sometimes what God does for you and does through you, it looks crazy to folk, and folk are doubting what's happening to you. Here it is in the text. Here it is in the text. It says that Mary found favor. She found favor. Mary was impregnated. Mary was impregnant. And about this time she was impregnant, what happened was that Joseph now, because he was worried about what folk was going to say, Joseph tried to put her away or divorce her quietly. You got to understand, when you gifted, you got to understand that there are some people that will try to get rid of you, and there are some folk that will walk out on you when they don't understand what's going on in you. Okay, y'all missed that. See, there are some people that will walk out on you and turn their backs on you when they don't know what's going on in you. Okay, let me see. So let me give you 3 points so y'all can get to the store, spend all y'all money, come back, ask me for a loan. I ain't got it. Here it is. So with me, I said, so when you, when God, watch this, but if you're gifted, you got to understand that every good and perfect gift comes from above. But it's complicated because it involves others. So what God, what was in her was getting ready to change the world, but what was in her, she needed others to help her bring forth out of her. Okay, so if you understand, what do you mean it was connect? When you're dealing with a gift that's complicated, you have to be sure to connect with people who can commit to what they haven't caused. Let me rewind that. When you're gifted, you got to make sure you're connected to the right people. You got to be make sure that you can connect to the people, you can be connected to people who can commit to you, commit to something that they didn't have a hand in. It's easy to commit to your idea about me. But can you commit to somebody else's dream, somebody else's vision, somebody else's gift? See, when you are gifted and it's complicated and people don't even understand how you gifted when they had nothing to do with it, can you have to make sure that the people that are around you don't try to abort what's in you because they can't commit to what's in you? He says, watch this. You got to understand, Joseph, once Joseph heard from the angel and Joseph understood that this was something spiritual going on, he was all in. Even though it wasn't his idea, even though he wasn't in on the process or even on the decision or even on the planning, he committed to her. And instead of getting rid of her, he took her and protected her. See, you got to have somebody in your life that's going to protect what's in you from people that don't understand why God did it for you. You must understand that there are some things in your life that if you're going to connect to people, and even to the point where you still really don't understand what's going on in your life, you got to make sure that you're connected to some people that can protect you from people that have problems with the packaging. Watch this. The reason why you got to head out where you got to have the right people committed to you is because people around you will have problems with the packaging. Okay, you missed that. You missed that. You missed that. You watch this. They watch this. They want the gift, but they don't want what's in the gift, what's wrapped around the gift. Some people look at you and say, how can you put something so great in him? They don't have problem with the package. They have a problem with the packaging. They watch this. But truth be told, you can't worry about that because people think that what you've done is insurmountable and God can't use you. It's not that God can't use you. They don't want God to use you. Okay? It's not that God can't do something through you. It's just that they living in their unforgiveness and they don't believe you deserve anything great. But God looks beyond your faults and God sees your needs, and God will package his gift in anything he sees fit. He's sovereign. Watch this. Here you go. See, this is for all of you all that got a problem with the packaging. I don't want you to miss out on what's in me because it is me. Oh, you missed that. Okay. See, two feet tall, you got people that's going to miss out on what's in you because it is you. But if you stop worrying about it being me, you'll get what God is doing through me. Oh, God. You got to understand that God is trying to use the unusable. God is trying to use those that the world deems are not usable. But if you keep looking at the packaging, you'll miss out on the package. Oh, God. Well, I don't know who that's for. Some of us are getting frustrated. Some of us are thinking we are inadequate. Some of us are feeling useless because folk keep rejecting us. They're not rejecting you. They're rejecting what's in you. And they get so caught up on the who that they miss out on the what. What do you mean, Pastor Kevin? You so caught up on the who that you miss out on the what is God. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, you better look beyond me so you can experience what's in me. God is using me to deliver something that's going to change the world. Okay, let me, I'm done. Really, I'm done. But you must understand, God uses the unusable. And we only can receive from packages that's been wrapped by Gucci. But you will not receive something that's coming out of a hoochie. Okay, you missed that. You missed that. Okay. But God can use even a hoochie when you're looking for Gucci. And God is trying to bring something out of some places that people wouldn't look for great stuff. That's why God used David, even after David made a mistake. That's why God took Saul and changed his name to Paul. That's why God used Peter, even after he cut off somebody's ear and denied him three times. You don't know. You don't believe that. Look at you. He's still using you, even though you jacked up, even though your pack is kind of raggedy, even though your bow ain't straight, God still is using you, and there's something in you that God is trying to get out of you. The gift is complicated, but look at this. This is what's so bright. This is what you got folk hating on what's in you, and you didn't even ask for it. Okay, now that's the problem. They think you paid for this. They think you manipulated your way to this. They think you did some backdoor stuff. But truth be told, Mary didn't even ask for this. Mary was all right with just being Joseph's little wife, being this little peasant. But God showed up and put something in her that she didn't even ask for. And truth be told, most gifted people didn't even ask for gifted to be gifted because they didn't want the headache that comes. You know how it is when you the best one, when you just do stuff with ease. You didn't even ask for this. It's because you're just gifted. Allen Iverson said it like this: practice. Who needs practice? Okay, y'all missed that. He said, because I'm just good like that. But truth be told, there's things that people stay up late trying to figure out where you wake up late and get it done because you're just gifted. God has put something in Mary, and people don't understand how can you can use a peasant girl to deliver what you say going to deliver me. Okay, watch this. I got to turn this off. I don't even want to use this because I got to show y'all something. The text says she was delivering something that was going to deliver the world. But what does scripture say? Put the scripture up, brothers. I just went back to my teaching mode. Put the scripture up. The scripture says, go ahead, go down. Okay, espoused wife, okay. Okay, here we go, there you go. It says, while they were being counted, watch this, let me pause here right here to help you out. It says they were in the city, they went in the city to be counted. It was the census. But they were counting, but they weren't counting what's in her. They was only counting her. And truth be told, you can't count me without counting what's in me. Okay, because I'm more than what you see. Okay, here it is. That was just a part. I wasn't even for you. I'm more than what you see. But anyway, but then it says, and so it was that thou, while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be what? Okay, no. She was delivering. She was delivering something to deliver us. Okay. But what the text say? What the text say? You ain't got your glasses on, Chris. Somebody get Chris some glasses. It said it was time for her to be delivered. You missed it. You missed it. See, we out here trying to deliver others, but we first got to be delivered ourselves. Watch this. It says the thing that she was going to birth out was going to deliver others. He said, but before I can use what's in you to deliver others, I got to deliver you. You must understand that God is going to first work on you before he works through you. God Almighty, I need you to understand. You got too many bound folk trying to deliver folk. But God says, what I'm going to do for the world, I'm going to do through you. So before I can get it to them, I got to get it done through you.
They don't want to hear that. They want to keep trying to deliver folk jacked up.
God says it was time for her to be delivered. Not only is what in me going to deliver you, but it's going to deliver me too. That's why I tell you, I don't be preaching to you. I be preaching through me to you. And whatever God is preaching to you, he's doing it for me at the same time. I'm not up here being judgmental. I'm preaching a word that can deliver me too. Everybody want to preach to, but not through. I got a word for you. What about the word through me to you? Because before it can get to you, I was sitting here last week, and my daughter, my niece, who mom just passed, she couldn't eat nothing. I said, all this food we got, you're not eating nothing? And she said, yeah, because Grant is allergic to eggs, butter, and all the, and everything is cooked in butter and stuff. I said, well, that ain't got nothing to do with you. She said, no, because I nurse him. And whatever I put in me affects him. Y'all missed it right there. She said, because I'm nursing him and because other people are depending on what I put in me to help them, I got to watch what I put in me. Watch this. So in order for me to give him something that won't make him sick, I got to make sure I'm not eating anything that's going to make me sick. That's why he says, before you can deliver something that's going to deliver others, you have to first yourself be delivered. You cannot keep putting stuff in you that makes other people sick and expect people to grow. God put deliverance in you. So now you have to understand that it's going to deliver you as you deliver others. So they were being counted, and now it says it was time for her to be delivered. Watch this. And now it says that after the baby was born, they wrapped him in a swaddling clothes and put him in a manger. Put him in a manger because there was no room at the inn. Watch this. Now you got one thing you got to realize. One of the things that if you know that you that is a complicated gift is that you must realize that you're gonna have to have the dexterity to deliver through difficulty.
Okay, I know y'all. That was.
Watch this. You're going to have the dexterity. You're going to have to be flexible when you're pregnant with promise, you're pregnant with possibilities, you're pregnant with and you're gifted with something that's going to change the world. You got to be flexible, and you cannot allow the fact that folk are rejecting you to keep you from delivering what's in you. Okay. It says she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for him at the inn. Okay, it was no room for them at the inn. They were rejected at the inn because there was no room, they thought they were going to deliver this. They were going to deliver this great dream, this great possibility in a mega church. Okay, y'all missed that right here. They thought surely they were going to have the red carpet rolled out because they were gifted. They thought surely they were going to get the penthouse suite down on Park Avenue, and surely they were going to have spacious room, and they were going to have midwives, and they were going to have everything around them. They were going to have the balloons and everything because they were delivering something that was going to deliver them. But truth be told, when your gift is complicated, people will shut doors in your face in hopes that you abort what's in you. But when you know you're gifted with something great, you are flexible. I don't have
have to deliver it in a mega church. I can deliver it in a storefront. I don't have to deliver it when everybody is around. I can deliver it when nobody is looking. He said, because what's in me got to come out of me. Okay, so I said, let me see if I can help you right here. Let me see if I can help right here. It says, what happens is you have to be nimble. You have to be mentally agile. You have to be skillful enough to deliver even when there's no room for them in the end. Okay, watch this, watch this. So what God is trying to tell some of us is that some of us are gifted. Some of us have something great in us. Some of us have promise in us. What's in us is going to change what's around us. He says, but I want to see if you can push it out in a difficult spot. Watch this. That's why some of us have gone through so much hell this year. It's because God wanted to see if you can still deliver through difficulty. He wanted to see if you can still push what's in you out of you when folk is trying to press up against you. He wanted to see if you can still deliver greatness in a bad situation. He wants to still can see if you can deliver good news when everybody else around you is trying to give you bad news. He said, so just because they don't have room for you at the end don't mean that what's in you can't come out of you. You cannot delay this thing. Watch this. Let me get up you. I'm done. I'm going to give you some definitions. The word manger simply means a feeding trough. It's a feeding trough. It's a stall. Watch this. He says, so now not only did they not allow you to be in the penthouse, they pushed you to a stall. Watch this. Now, a stall is a compartment for one domestic animal in a barn or a shed. It's a booth, a cubicle. You know how it is when you work in the building and they don't give you your office that overlooks the city. They put you in a cubicle. They put you in a small spot. It is a small part that's used by a vendor or somebody that's not going to be there forever. Okay, you missed that. He says, watch this. It's a small compartment. Watch this. And the word stall also is a tactic used to mislead or delay. Let me come back, give you all of it together. It says a manger is a feeding trough. It's a stall. A stall is a compartment for one domestic animal in a barn or a shed. It's a booth, a cubicle, or it's a small compartment. A stall is also a tactic used to mislead or delay. Let me say it one more time. A manger is a feeding trough or a stall. A stall is a compartment for one domestic animal in a barn or a shed. It's a booth or a cubicle for vendors, for people that's not going to always be there. It's a small compartment, but a stall is also a tactic used by people to mislead you and to delay you. Let me see if I can help you right here. It was time for her to birth what's in her, and the people around her were trying to delay her from delivering what's going to deliver you. Okay, let me see if I can help you. Poopy troll, that some of us think that the reason why God is putting us and we're going through difficulty and we in a tight spot is because God is mad at us. It's not because God is mad at us. It's because people trying to delay what you getting ready to deliver. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, I don't care how tight things get. I don't care how rough things get. You can't delay what God has called me to deliver. You can't stop what God is pushing out of me. I'm not going to allow you to back me up into a place where I put this on hold, because God is doing something through me. I don't care how small I got to deliver it. I don't care if I got to deliver it in the back of a car. I don't care if I got to deliver it in the back of a room. You don't understand that it's coming out of me. Oh, God. Let me see. What happens is that when people reject you, they trying to stall what's in you. I know y'all hate the words, but I'm just following what the words say. God, you got to stop getting mad and fighting with people that don't let you have room at the end, because while you're fighting, you're delaying your deliverance. Ooh, good God Almighty. Because it was time for her to be delivered. And when you so busy fussing at the front desk clerk because they tell you there's no vacancy, you are delaying your deliverance. You want to know why we ain't been delivered yet? Because we fussing with folk for room. And God says, you don't need room. Wherever you try, wherever you push, it's coming out of you. Wherever you push, it's coming out of you. And you have to understand that the more you try to beg people for space, you're delaying what God is trying to push through you. God, put me up. Put me up. I need to preach next Sunday. Put me up next year until you, okay, I ain't going to deliver this word until you put me up. What if I don't put you up for 2 years? Are you going to allow me, am I your God? Are you preaching for me? Or is it time for you to be? Because watch this. Even if I don't put you up, you can't, when it's time to be delivered, the contractions become so close apart that you ain't got time to wait for room. Watch this. You ain't got time. Watch this. You're going to have to, your husband in the front seat telling baby, breathe, 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 breathe. You saying, hurt, breathe, breathe, breathe. And then while you up there trying to tell her to be calm, she's realizing how much she hate you because this your fault. And then what you realize is that the contractions are too close apart that you ain't got time to get to Inova Fairfax. You got to pull over on the side of the road. And I don't know who that's for, but some of us have been on our way to the perfect spot to deliver what's in us. We've been waiting. We getting ready to join First Baptist Church of Glenard. We getting ready to born Ebenezer. We packing up, getting ready to move to the pot house. But God told me you got to pull over at the tab and deliver it in a small spot, because this thing can't wait until you get the spotlight. When you deliver what's in you, the spotlight gonna find you. Look at your neighbors and push it out of you. You cannot wait for the perfect spot to deliver what's in you. You'll know when it's time. When you can't wait. You can't wait. When you can't wait for assistance. But it's up to you. Are you flexible? Or have you leaned to your own understanding? Wow. Wow. I was just sharing it with Ms. Tamika this morning. I never want to be no pastor, no church. I was the facilities director. I wanted to stop the leaks in the walls so that my father's vision could go forth. I ain't know nothing about no change, no diapers. Ain't no daycare. Even though Shaquita make me change them all the time now. Come on, we out of ratio. Ain't know nothing about that stuff. This is not what I wanted to do. This was not my understanding about where I was going to deliver. But when it was time for me to be delivered, God, good God Almighty, there comes a time when it's time for you to be delivered. And you can't wait for the perfect spot. Whatever God got in you, you got to push it up. And my father installed me as pastor on Friday, October the 29th. I preached my first message as pastor on October 20, on that 31st, that Sunday morning. I was scared as a dog. And everybody, I don't care who you are, everybody was looking at me saying, now let me see what you're going to say. And I stood up. And I've been preaching for 8 years now, but that was my greatest message. That was my greatest message that I preached. And I didn't even know that was in me. But it was time for me to be delivered. And no matter where you are in life, when it's time for you to be delivered, it's time for you to be delivered. Whether it's on Capitol Hill or on the hills of Garfield Terrace, you're going to deliver it. Because what's going to deliver you is going to deliver those around you. This woman was pregnant with the Savior. What if she'd have been mad, fussing? What if she'd been 2,000 years later, she's still talking about, you gonna give me a room? 2,000 years later, we'd be still stuck on stupid because the person carrying what was gonna change my life is so busy fighting over folk that won't give them room. Who are you looking to give you room that won't give you room and you refuse to deliver what's in you?
2019, we're not going into 2019 fighting over space. We got faith for new. God is not going to allow you to keep what's in you, because what's in you is not just for you, it's for those around you. You wonder why your family ain't delivered yet? Because you won't get delivered. You wonder why the people you love, the people you've been praying for, because you won't deliver. You won't get delivered. You keep fighting over folk. You keep arguing with folk. You keep trying to manipulate your way to the front. You keep trying to manipulate your way to the Elizabeth Taylor suite at Washington Hospital Center to be delivered, because you refuse to deliver in a dirty bathroom down on the basement floor. You better push it out of you. If you push it out in the bathroom, the janitor get delivered. Wherever you push it out, somebody gonna get delivered. I could just see those horses and those domestic animals in that stall leaping because my Savior was just delivered. All creation rejoice. Today, I know the gift complicated. I know people don't understand you, Gwen. I know people don't understand you, Paul. Devon, I know people don't understand you. I know people don't understand you. They don't understand you because it's complicated. Because they're looking at it through natural eyes. When people look at me, they say, Kevin, I the same thing I said. Kevin? I was telling Sister Demiga this morning, I sat at the table at my first executive board meeting. I say this, Paul. I said at the meeting, my father just installed me pastor, interim pastor. He died on me. Installed me, telling me I'm going to walk with you through this process. And then I'm going to install you as senior pastor next year sometime. And you die 2 weeks later before you can even walk me through this. And I'm thinking that it's complicated. I don't understand what you're doing. I don't know nothing about pastoring no church. Now they tell me, oh, you know it's time for the executive board meeting. I said, executive board meeting, what's that? And my wife looked at me. She said, Kevin, you got to get courage. You got to lift up your head now. I said, darling, I can't do this. I don't even want to do this. My intention when my father died, I was going to walk beside my father. When he died, I was going to join First Baptist. That was my understanding, because I knew not a man. I was going to where I thought somebody could help me or I could help somebody else. I was okay with just being a midwife. I didn't think I would have something in me. I sat at the table. Right here in this back room. And it's so funny you made me talk about it this morning. We were sitting there and she just asked me. And I sat there in the back and it was a table. We had the elders on the outside. My wife's sitting right there. I'm sitting at the head of the table and I'm sitting with my head down because I didn't want this. I didn't want this. I said, this is not what I want. I said, these people done changed my diapers. These people knew me when I was at my worst. I don't deserve this. And I was sitting at the table, God knows, and I was ready to tell them, y'all take it. And somebody at the table said, don't worry about it. In 6 months, you're going to beg us to take it back. And I lifted up my head. I was getting ready to give it up because I thought I wasn't worthy. And somebody at the table don't know what was meant for evil lifted up my head. They said, don't worry about it. In 6 months, you're going to beg us to take this back. It wasn't never yours in the first place. And I got my help. I set up. I said, either I'm going, he says, we're going to win or I'm going to die trying. And from that day forth, I was delivered. And so, and guess what? So don't worry, because some of the rejection that you're getting is delivering you. What the enemy meant for evil delivered you. And it was something in me that I didn't know was in me, but it stood up that day. And I'm telling you that God is standing up in you today. Because folk think you ain't going to make it. Folk think you're going to throw it down. Folk trying to get you, talk you out of what God is doing through you, but you better lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be delivered. But you don't get delivered to throw it in nobody's face. You deliver so it can deliver the people that said you couldn't be delivered. God ain't delivering you for you to throw it up in people's face. But God wanted to remind you where you were 8 years ago, getting ready to throw in the towel on your future. How many of us got a testimony that we would have fainted had we not believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living? And you lifted up your heads. It's a complicated gift. You can't expect everybody to understand it. You can expect people to have problems with the packaging, but it's gifted. You still gifted. No matter how people see you, you still gifted. If you don't get nothing under the tree this week, you got a gift, and it's called Jesus Christ. If nobody sends you nothing, you gifted. Give yourself a gift and push. Give yourself a gift and push. Don't allow nobody to talk you out of what God has put in you. It's up to them if they want to miss out on the what because of the who God decides to use. God is saying in this season, no matter how tight you might be, I don't care how tight your finances are, I don't care how tight what's going on in your family, God is saying that's where I need you to be delivered at. If you could be delivered in a tight spot, everything around you can be delivered in a tight spot. And when you get delivered, good God Almighty, let's stand, let's go home. Telling you, I don't need nothing on the tree. I don't need nothing. I don't need nothing under the tree because he died for me on the tree. And I'm gifted. Gift is complicated. He didn't say it was going to be easy, but it's going to be worth it. And sometimes what we need is a little push from some rejection. Sometimes we need folk that don't believe in us. That's why you got to stop running away haters. It's the haters that help you lift up your head. Stop running away people that's helping you get delivered. That's why he told Paul, Paul said, take this thorn away from me. He says, I will not, but my grace is sufficient. And God is saying, whatever you need. He says, I'm done. I got to go. I got to. When you get delivered, one of the things that I realized, we were saying in the Bible study the other night, is sometimes we get so comfortable. We get so comfortable that we're no longer any good to anybody. This is the penthouse, the folk. We stay in the church. This is the penthouse. And everything we deliver to church folk. Everything we deliver, we deliver to church folks. Everything we birthed out in a comfortable spot. God can't get us to go into community and birth out nothing in the community because we're comfortable. And that's what happened with the early church. We going home. I'm done. God knows I'm done. That's what happened to the early church. What happened to the early church? It says that thousands were joining when Peter preached, and God added to the church daily, and they began to grow so much. Peter and John started going out, and they were preaching, and everybody was sitting around waiting on Peter and John to preach. Everybody was waiting till Sunday so they could hear Pastor Kevin preach. All week long, they sat around waiting to hear somebody preach. And that's what's wrong with the church. We sitting around all week long doing nothing, waiting to hear somebody preach. And God says, this is not doing anything for the commission to go out in the world. And he sent persecution, and they were scattered. And sometimes the persecution that comes in your life is because you done got comfortable listening to somebody else preach. And God trying to get you out of the space. He trying to tell you there's no more room for you at the end. Go deliver it in God-filled church. Go deliver it at Salvation Army. Go deliver it in the senior building around the corner. Go deliver it around the corner. Go get a bullhorn and push what's out of you. Stop sitting in here waiting for room in the end, and God is pushing you. Everybody here waiting on the word. You are the word made flesh. You are the word made flesh. Whenever God speaks a word to you, you become that word. Now take that word to the world. Stop running in here every Sunday. I want you to come to church. We need infrastructure, but this is not where we live. You're not going to leave here and wait for our preaching again next Sunday. Take the word that you are and go into the community and be delivered. Be delivered. The gift that's in you is for you. Be delivered. Father, we thank you. We worship you on today. I'm tired of trying to explain what you're doing through me. Mary never explained it to Joseph. He had to get it from the Spirit. When God is doing something great in you, stop trying to explain it to everybody. You spend more time trying to explain it than you do trying to deliver it. Some stuff just cannot be explained. I don't know why he used somebody that was sleeping behind a liquor store. I can't explain it. Stop asking me to tell you how I did it. I didn't do it. He did it. He still decided to use me. I'm gifted, and it's complicated. It's complicated. I don't understand. I should be dead, sleeping in my own grave. It's complicated. It's complicated. So stop asking me. I don't know. All I know is he said the Holy Spirit did it. Stop trying to prove yourself to other people and just be delivered. It's complicated, Devon. People don't understand you. Stop trying to explain it. In silence, you gain your strength. In silence, you gain your strength. In silence, you gain your strength. The reason why we weak is because we talking too much, trying to explain, trying to convince people that we gifted. Stop trying to convince people and just be delivered. That's it. I'm done. Come on, let's go home. I'm done. I just figured out what it was. Theo, I just figured out what it was. I just figured out what it was. I just figured out what he was delivering her from was people. I just figured out. It just told me that what he was delivering her from was people. That's why he used somebody that people had problems with the packaging. He says, because I want you to deliver with people, deliver you from people. You're no good to me if you're worried about what people think. That's why she knew no man. I want to deliver you from people. I want you to stop being in the prison of people's understanding about what you should do. I'm delivering you from people. This year, God is delivering you from people. Matter of fact, let me get down here. This year, God is delivering you from people. The only reason why you ain't been delivered yet is because you press and you trying to press people. But God said he delivered you from people this year in the name of Jesus. God is delivering you from people. The only thing keeping you down is you worried about what people think. But God is delivering you from people in the name of Jesus. He's delivering you from people. It's people that got you stuck. It ain't nothing. Oh, foolish Galatians, who hindered you that you didn't run well? It's you, because you are not delivered from people's opinion of you. What the? What did Joseph say? He says, I'm going to put away quietly because of what people going to say. Is that what the text says? The text says, Joseph said, I'm going to put her away because of what people going to say. And God didn't allow her to be put away, even though in God, he has made it so more that he made her go and be counted. Be counted. Be counted. Be counted. Be counted. Don't let nobody count you out. They got to count you in. The next great thing God delivers through you is going to deliver you from people. Be delivered. Be delivered. Be delivered. Be delivered. Be done. Everybody have a very good Christmas. But as you go, be delivered from people. Be delivered from people. It'll save you a lot of money. It'll save you a lot of money. It'll save you a lot of stress. And God will burst things out of you that folk they couldn't get through you. Be delivered. Shama. I just got it, Paul. I just got it. It's the people that's keeping me back. It's the people. I gotta be delivered from people. Be delivered from people. Be delivered from people. It's complicated. That's why God couldn't let nobody help you. That's why folk couldn't help you. It ain't that they didn't want, they couldn't. Because God said, I need you to get delivered from people. Because where I'm taking you, going to be lonely sometimes. And you know not a man. Be delivered from people. Be delivered from people. I walked in a room. And one of the sinners we run. And one of the staff members saw me coming. And turned around and walked away like, I'm not speaking to you. I said, I've been delivered. She thought giving me the silent treatment was going to make me lose my mind and run and try to explain the complicated gift in me. I said, I've been delivered. And she said, she's going to run into the corner and run into the corner. I said, I lease that spot too. But we done. That is what God. In order. This is the setup. This is the setup. I need y'all to come back. New Year's Eve. I don't know how, but God just set it up. If you're going to have faith for the new, you got to be delivered from people. You gotta be delivered from people. You gotta be delivered from people. You gotta learn how to be comfortable in your complicated gift. Everybody, God bless you. Everybody have a Merry Christmas. I love you, but be delivered from people.
Be delivered from people.
Yeah!